Huh? Packing the mail, it's gone. She like I smell cologne.
Yeah, I just signed a deal, I'm on.
Yeah, yeah. I go where I want, good. Play if you want, let's do it. I'm a young CEO, sure. Yeah. First nigga play, I'ma body a nigga. I just check my balance, I'll probably pull up to your hood and come buy me a nigga. No cap. You know.
Welcome to the Enterprises Elite Podcast. Today we will be answering questions that people have about real estate in our Discord. Now they have exclusive access to me as a mentor. They have our contracts, they have our scripts, and they have basically everything you need to succeed in this business. So guys, today we're gonna be answering some questions. John, do you have any favorite questions? By the way, Bang, if you're watching this, you obviously should be in our emails because we're making millionaires using your energy drink in the video here. So
you've helped create millionaires, honestly. This yes. drink has some bullshit in it that creates millionaires.
I think there's millions of dollars in it.
Inside of it, somehow.
So let's focus on what are these guys saying?
Like, I don't even know where to start, to be honest. So I'm going to scroll up. All right, so this is a good one. For anyone watching this, you're probably a beginner, so we're going to start here. This kid named Mystical45. Shout out to you. That's an OG member right there. So he goes, I'm just confused on how to start, where to start. Like, I read the cold calling script. And do I need to find a realtor or something? Because it sounds like a third person needs to be involved besides the seller and buyer and me.
As far as parties in the transaction, there's really only two. There's the seller and the buyer. You're just connecting the two.
Yeah.
So in the process of wholesaling, all you're doing is you're getting an agreement with a seller, and then you're selling your position in that agreement to the buyer. So in other words, you basically are selling your rights to the property. You need a license to sell real estate. You do not need a license to sell your rights to buy real estate. That is what wholesaling is. You're selling your position in a legally binding agreement that only you have the access to. So as soon as John and I agree to a price of $100,000, mm-hmm. we both sign. John can't sell to anybody else for any price. So he's locked in for $100,000. But what I'm doing is I'm saying, instead of Joel Riley, I'm going to sell it to David. Okay. Mm-hmm. And David is going to pay $120. So now I use an assignment of contract, which you can find in the Discord. And I just get that assignment of contract signed by David. Mm-hmm. I bring those two contracts to an attorney and they cut me a check for the $20,000. If you need any contract at all for real estate, we can get you it in the Discord. Same with the script that you use. Okay. So here's how you get started. Okay. You pull a list of motivation. You can find that list on propstream.com. Once you pull that list from propstream.com, you need to call that list with our script. When you call that list, just get comfortable speaking to sellers. Make 100 phone calls. You should get I got my first two deals in my first 100 phone calls.
Guys, the hardest part in anything, especially businesses and working for yourself, is starting. You're going to have to get over that curve somehow. Mm-hmm. You know. So can you recommend anything to kind of break the ice for a beginner?
Am I allowed to say it? I'm going to say it anyway.
Say it anyways, dude.
Liquor worked for me. my first couple of deals. That's what I did. I was drinking Kahlua, actually.
You want to know what's funny, though? Kids will go to college and get fucked up every single day for 4 years straight and not make a dime from that.
Mm-hmm.
You turn that fucking drinking session into $50,000, bro. So you used alcohol to your advantage, bro.
Deals, yeah.
Make sure you're above 21 and plus if you want to use that tactic.
Right. Anybody drinking anything.
But you can use Bang Energy.
Yeah, Bang Energy also works.
Yep.
Okay, but if you want to, you know, get some liquid confidence in you for the first couple phone calls, who am I to blame you?
Yeah,
you know
what I mean? Seriously. I am Irish,
though. I will. Full disclosure, I am Irish.
I thought you were half fish. half fish, half Irish.
Vodka, water, what's the difference? So anyway.
Next question. Okay. Shout out to the Happy Cub. He's a Discord member, and he said, can anyone help me get my first deal? I found a foreclosure property for $600,000 on Zillow.
Mm.
Damn, that sounds pretty high. And then he goes, and the house looks really distressed. I checked the neighborhood houses that are around the area.
He must be in California.
And he said they're all the same square footage, and they're all selling for around 700 plus.
Okay,
so he's got to be.
I'll tell you what, too high, bro. Mm-hmm. Way too high.
The Happy Cup. Okay. I hope you're listening.
Okay, here's how you calculate your offer price. I'm gonna spit some game right now. Listen closely. you get your after repair value. That is determined from properties in that neighborhood that are similar in size, 10% up, 10% down in square feet, okay? Similar size, bedrooms, bathrooms, okay? All in mint condition. That is your after repair value. Get three of those. Now you average those together and you know what the property's worth. Next step, you multiply that number times 70%. Okay, that is the flipper's profit margin. So your flipper needs to make a 30% margin. That's where you get that formula from. So you get ARV times 70% and you subtract the repairs. That way, after the flipper puts the money in, he makes a 30% margin. Okay, once that's done, you subtract your profit from that. Okay, so 70% of ARV minus repairs minus your wholesale fee. That is how you calculate your offer, okay? So you get the property under contract for that number. Typically, it's you should start at about 50% of ARV as an offer, okay? If they come back and you can negotiate 60 to 65% or below that, then you most likely have a deal if the property is not completely trashed, okay? If it needs cosmetic updates, you have a deal, okay? So now, the next step, if you're in our Discord, we sell the deal for you, okay? So you don't even have to worry about building a buyer's list or anything like that, okay? That's a major service we provide. We will get your deal sold so you don't have to worry about finding a buyer. I have buyers up my ass, bro. They're calling me every fucking day.
If you have watched our YouTube videos, even our first YouTube video, we're like mid-recording.
And I made 12 grand
off of that phone call. He gets a fucking call that made him 12 grand later that day, you know?
No, we were filming a video of me at a flip, and then I get a call from a buyer while I'm on camera, coincidentally, just make 12 grand real quick in a phone call because these buyers are hungry and ready to go.
Passively.
You can even be an affiliate. All you have to do is post our content. You can make passive income from it. Like a rental property, you can create in passive income every week.
While
just from posting our content, literally.
Laying in bed, making money. Okay, here's a good one. Because this guy clearly doesn't know what he's talking about. The amount of people wholesaling already is crazy. This shit is way too saturated.
Okay.
Best bet is to get 3 to 5 like-minded people, come together, buy a property together, flip it, do that multiple times, and slowly branch out on your own. Just unsubscribed, LOL.
Here's the deal. That is called a scarcity mindset. This is a common, it's very common, actually.
No, don't give him free clout.
I won't expose him, but he will lose. He will lose, that's for sure. All right, you cannot win with a scarcity mindset, okay? Guys, we're talking about real estate. There is trillions and trillions and trillions, hundreds of trillions of dollars worth of real estate. To act like the market is too saturated would be hurting yourself so badly because now you're going to think in terms of scarcity. If you're thinking in terms of scarcity, you're penny pinching and you will never succeed. You need to focus on getting more money. And here's the deal. If it's a competitive market, that's a sign you're in the right market, okay? So what my friend here did incorrectly is he looked at competition like a bad thing. Competition is a great thing, especially in real estate, because you can collaborate with these people. The more wholesalers you know, your network is your network.
He didn't have the abundant mindset.
Right. So you got to be thinking differently, okay? Yep. If you're thinking in terms of, oh my God, I'm at a barbecue and I need to eat it all up the food because, there's not enough chicken here. We can't have you. You know what I mean? There's plenty to go around. Trust me. I have huge wholesalers in my market. I've never run into them. Never run into them ever. Okay. So, and we talk to the same lists of people. So to think that way, you're just hurting yourself. I just want to mention, you got to have an abundance mindset to be in this industry.
Yep. The penny pinchers, guys. Nah. There's a reason why you are penny pinching.
Yeah. You can't be penny pinching $25, bro. If you don't invest into your own brain, you are screwed.
Yeah, you're screwed, guys. You're gonna
That's the best investment you can make. It's better than any real estate property. And trust me, one of my first deals, I paid $8,000 for a property I still own today. It was 3 years ago. It was with an FHA loan. I've talked about it briefly. That property alone will make me well over $1 million. For $8,000, where else can you make that trade other than real estate? In your brain. That is where you can invest, okay? Invest into your own knowledge, and you will reap a crazy return on investment, especially if you're young. Okay.
Nice.
What other questions?
Nice. I like that. Oh, I just hit the fucking mic hard as fuck.
You good?
All right. Do you buy leads?
I mean, so in my company, I want to talk about the how to look at this. So I don't buy leads. I create leads. I generate leads. In other words, I purchase lists of prospects. Now, you need to understand the terminology if you're a business owner, especially if you're getting into this industry. There's a difference between leads and prospects. Big defining difference. You cannot call prospects leads. I buy lists by the thousands of prospects. I've probably spent $100,000 on just lists of people's names and phone numbers. They are not leads. The difference between a prospect and a lead is somebody who you've asked if they want to sell and they said yes. At that point in time, you need to put them in your CRM. We use Podio.
Which is short for?
Customer Relationship Management Program.
Mm.
Okay. This is where you store all of your leads and you follow up with them until they either buy or fucking die. Okay.
I love that. Because
here's the deal. Once they've told you yes, they need to tell you they're going to sue you for you to get them off your fucking list.
Ooh,
because here's
shit.
The deal. Here's the deal. Everybody's situation changes. So if somebody said, yes, I'm interested in selling, I don't care if it's in 2 years. Call them every month. Because eventually something could happen, bro.
Yeah.
They could need to go to Florida because of a job transfer next month. You don't know unless you ask. So you need to follow up with those leads. Have them in your CRM permanently. You need to prioritize leads in a way that, you know, the hot leads, you call them more frequently. And then you have the long-term nurture leads where you call every month or so just to check in to see if anything changed. That's how you run a business.
So you, obviously, you've done this many times.
Yes.
Do you ever feel like you're, like, annoying them?
I don't give a fuck.
Yeah.
And actually, that was a learning curve for me.
And the reason why I asked that is because there's probably kids out there who are... don't want to feel like that.
No,
you guys got to have some tough skin.
I've actually felt that exact thing. You have to get over that because getting over that fear is where the money's at. Listen, today was a short episode. We got to wrap it up. Next episode, we're going to come back and answer some more Discord questions because we can provide a ton of value.
A ton, guys.
A ton of value. If you want to get into this business, there's no better place to be than on this podcast or in the Discord or both. Probably both.
Yeah.
So everything you need is in our Discord: contracts, scripts, my mentorship, JV partners, a great network of like-minded individuals that are not afraid to invest in their own knowledge. So guys, tune in next week. We will see you then. And our goal is always to make you fucking rich. So, and we want you to tell your friends about it when you get rich. So guys, come back next week. We'll talk to you soon.
Oh Lord, listen, made another one.
Huh? Packing the mail, it's gone. She like I smell cologne.
Yeah, I just had the deal, I'm on.
Yeah, yeah. I go where I want, good. Play if you want, it's do it. I'm a young CEO, sure. Yeah. The first nigga play, I'ma body a nigga. I just check my balance, I'll probably pull up to your hood and come buy me a nigga. Nope.